Welcome back everybody to the grand final of the Prime Major Tournament. This is of course Sig.Tr Trust going up against the Prime. It is a best of three. The Prime had a one game advantage, but Sig.Tr Trust managed to win game number one after a really just back and forth game there. Both teams got a couple of racks in their favor, but Sig.Tr just being able to get their own buybacks off cooldown a little bit earlier meant that they could repel the final GG push of the Prime and then go for the counter GG themselves. But this is game number 3, the last and deciding one here. Of course, unfortunately, this is not the best of 5, but even then, we had a great game. Well, on paper it was game number 2, but the first game that we actually saw being played. And now, this is game number 3 of the series, but the game, or the second game to be played. Looking at the bans though, the Prime removing a Queen of Pain plus a Lion. Lion definitely gave them a lot of trouble. Great Earth Spikes, of course Finger of Death, really hard to deal with in general. But Sig.Tr, once again, same bans, Chen and a Faceless Void. So for the Prime, Axe is available if they want to go for that one. If not, it's still like Enigma plus something. Although Sig.Tr now having the Vengeful Spirit means that even if you have an Enigma and he goes for a BKB, you still have something to just cancel the Black Hole with. But Juggernaut will be the first pick for them, and I don't think it's that surprising to be honest, because Sig.Tr, they showed in game number 1 how strong the Juggernaut could be, and having a Juggernaut and the Vengeful Spirit on the same side, meaning that if Sig.Tr wanted to pick it up, had the Prime gone for something else instead, it would have just meant easy Roshan's. Vengeance, or Wave of Terror rather, for the minus armor, and then Juggernaut in with the healing ward, with the Mask of Madness in the Roche pit, could easily even solo it, depending on the skill build that he went for. As well, it's just, I got distracted, was looking at Skype, maybe somebody has something important to say to me, but nope, nothing important guys, nothing more important than this game right here, right now. But Sig.Tr now, Troll Warlord is available, Axe of course, although Axe, I feel like most teams don't favor that hero as much anymore. Did get nerfed a little bit, the thresholds of the ultimate got reduced. For example, Aghanim's ultimate on level 3 is now 575 instead of 625. I think with the Aghanim's, all levels got like nerfed by 50, the threshold. So Sig.Tr, not gonna go for the Axe, a Batrider instead of that one. So, Batrider, Vengeful Spirit, definitely a strong combination. You can just track so many people out of position, whether it be via Lasso, or just swap somebody out. And of course, having the Vengeful Spirit on your own side means that there's no easy counter for the Prime to go for. You could try to go for like a Disruptor, but it's not the greatest. Glimpse may not be fast enough, plus Batrider, if he should choose to go for a BKB. Once he gets the BKB, suddenly Disruptor can't do anything at all. So the Prime, maybe they want to go for, let's say, a Slark, for example, is pretty nice up against Batrider, because if you're fast enough and you can pop the Dark Pact, you're still going to get rid even of a Lasso. And looking at the bans, Throw Ranger removed by the Prime. Of course, Sig.Tr to have two ranged heroes, but Sig.Tr taking out two of kind of the key heroes that the Prime have been running whenever given the chance. The Enigma as well as the Phoenix, and it really does look like Sig.Tr Trust. Them, first of all, having played the Prime in the upper bracket, maybe done some additional research, and now also having played game number 1, they just, they feel like, at least, are beginning to know the Prime more and more, knowing really what heroes they're successful with, what they're comfortable with, and really just banning out those same heroes. But the Prime now, wow. That's a pick that I didn't expect to come out at the moment, a Silencer. Not too sure yet whether it's going to be a support or core, but do you really want to like stop a champion of a Batrider with global silence? I just don't feel it for now. Maybe if there was something like a Faceless Void, of course, which is banned, or just maybe a Tidehunter or just something massive to follow up, but going for kind of a preemptive Silencer now. So Sig.Tr now, knowing that the Silencer is there, they can just go for heroes that can dish out a hell of a lot of damage just by attacking. Maybe even a Sniper somewhere along the line. But it's just hard to say. It really is. As now, Viper is the pick for the Prime. So going for a different lineup that we've seen out of them thus far. Of course, most of their heroes that they usually like to run are banned. So it makes sense that they have to pick for something else instead. But I'm not too sure if they're going to be comfortable enough or if they're going to be execute this kind of a draft the same way that they usually execute their other drafts. Storm Spirit, of course, still available as well for either side if they want to pick up that one. It's probably a little bit more likely now for Sig.Tr than the Prime. They could easily run a Storm Spirit safe lane, to be honest. Axe is still available if they even want to go a little bit greedy and run like a 4-position Axe. Maybe, just maybe run like a Batrider full-time jungle, but to be honest, I kind of prefer having no jungler when you have a Batrider on the same team, just to make sure that if the offlane is horrible for the Batrider, he can just come in, get those stacks going, farm those up with the Firefly stick in Napalm, of course, and kind of get an easy and reliable Blink Dagger that way. Whereas if you have a jungler, suddenly Batrider doesn't really have that fallback mechanic, will have to like farm up enemy jungle or just really participate heavily in kills, which isn't the easiest thing to do as a Batrider without the blink, and of course possibly without level 6 at the time as well. So Sig.Tr, what are we gonna see from them? Storm Spirit, of course, not as great now that there's a silencer on the enemy side, but apart from the silencer, it's not like they have a massive amount of lockdown to deal with a Storm Spirit. But seeing an IO for Sig.Tr, well, they would definitely like to have IO Tiny, I think, but IO Phantom Assassin might not be too bad either, up against what the Prime has. Up against Viper, maybe a little bit so, but... well, the Prime, they're less afraid of an IO Tiny combination than they are of an IO Morphling, it looks like. I mean, well, it's just IO Morphling. Yes, Lakels, he's an absolute beast of Morphling, probably like one of his best heroes, I would say, but the Prime now, going for a Brewmaster. So, Brewmaster, Viper, as well as a Juggernaut are their three cores. Juggernaut is one that can just take them latest, carry potential-wise. Viper, depending on your item build, can also do quite a bit. I mean, if you have like a Midas, so you definitely keep the farm coming, because flash farming for Viper just blows big time. Brewmaster, kind of the same story. Might see like a Power Dread or, well, Blink, then finishing up Power Dread possibly, and then into Midas, something like that. Just get Vladimir's Offering, for example, into AC, into Abyssal Blade, Brewmaster, something along those lines. Maybe Shiva's card along the way. But this is just pure speculation anyway for now. A Sig.Tr? They don't have that much time left, but it was the last pick that they needed to go for, so... definitely making use of reserve time makes sense in this kind of a position here, but Sig.Tr trust now. IO Tiny combination is the one that they ended up with. Maybe they did want to go for the Morphling because the Tiny definitely wasn't like an immediate pickup here. I would have loved to see CK, but that just won't happen ever, I think. Unfortunately so. But a solid lineup for Sig.Tr. Lanes should be strong enough as well, although the Prime, I'm not too sure if they want to leave, like, let's say, a Juggernaut solo up against Batrider. But then again, they could even quite easily run a Juggernaut aggressive try with Silencer and Witch Doctor. The one positive about such a try lane is that if you get the kill, Silencer can start racking up the intelligence early on. Whereas, of course, if it fails, your supports are extremely underleveled. Might not find anything, so maybe going into the own jungle is a little bit better. Also, gimping the Batrider a little bit, but with the tether already, they're making it so that the Batrider can at least place a ward and do so safely without it getting spotted out too easily. But to introduce the lineups, guys, for the last and deciding game of this final for the Prime Major Tournament, it is the Prime versus Sig.Tr. Hehe will be on the Batrider for the Dire side, leaving Shiro to support on the IO, who is rushing a straight out bottle. Mypro to handle the Shadowfiend heading towards the mid lane, Boombell on the Vengeful, and last is of course going to be Lakels on the Tiny. As for the Prime, Boo Boo, he is maybe going a little bit too deep, at least too deep ahead of his team. But Boo Boo is on the Silencer, Monang playing the Juggernaut, leaving Nafari on the Witch Doctor, Y2K to be the Brewmaster, and SCL handling the Viper, who is most likely going to be mid lane then. but they're placing down his sentry ward. Of course, immediately pinged out by Shiro. So he knows something is going on, but if he wants to rush a bottle, it means the boom bell has to go for the sentries. And it's not like that big of a deal for them to block this out, but IO definitely would otherwise camp or stack it up either for the Batrider or of course the Shadow Fiend. This Observer Ward though is like so-so. With this, I would expect an aggressive tri lane to be left behind, just because otherwise this aggressive vision, it gives you nothing else but knowledge that there are stacks. So the Prime, do they, for example, want to steal those stacks? Thunderclap, Blade Fury is like decent-ish with that, but it's really not the greatest, and that would mean that Juggernaut, unless he's on the top lane, that's just not gonna be a thing. So I'd say that Observer Ward may be a little bit wasted here. Of course, it can potentially like spot out the movements of, let's say, an IO, for example, who does want to come in and stack. But even so, maybe just blocking out another camp that the IO couldn't stack could have been put to a little bit of a better use, to be honest. But we still have a pause since Y2K is disconnected out on the Brewmaster. Oh, look at the IO, he's so shiny he shines through trees, although only at a certain angle. It's so weird. Why can I see the IO from here? Wow, okay, this is not the IO. What a shiny light bulb. Really, what is the IO like? How does he move around? How does he feel where something is? Like, purely sensory being. Does have some, like, wavy things radiating, so I guess this is his face side. Nice face, bro. Nice face. Man, there's not really much to talk about this early on. Nobody's really done anything. Just a pause. Of course, nobody's even saying anything. Why there's even a pause? Or maybe they did. I guess they did say sex, so that's nice. Or was there a pause straight out as well? I don't even remember. Okay, so our stats man. Man of Chalk. Our stats slash graphics man. Batrider. Whoa, highest win rate hero for them. 57%. It's not that high, to be honest, though. Yeah, Myth is signature thrust, so that's true enough, but it's 57%. I guess Myth or signature thrust in general don't have the best track record out there at the moment, even in Southeast Asia there. But they're a solid enough team. I mean, they've always been there, never really had like the greatest results. They were struggling quite hard a few months ago, but now it looks like they're a little bit better off with their current lineup, as well as just maybe the new sponsor makes it a little bit easier for them to possibly fully commit into Dota, for example. But Go has been given by Sig.Tr. Maybe the Prime themselves aren't ready yet, or never mind, they are. So we can get this game underway. It felt like the Prime are waiting for Sig.Tr. to randomly say Go, or never mind. I didn't even spot out Nafari asking for Go. So all is good. My bad, guys. Just a slight misunderstanding here as Boo. Well, having boots, you should be able to outrun most danger, even with a tether plus somebody chasing you down. But Shiro, having picked up a bounty rune, already has the bottle coming out. Of course, the second one to get the other bounty rune was SCL on the Viper, so whatever item he wants to go for is going to be a little bit faster as well, but there's a courier standing by Boo Boo. He's hiding in the trees. What's his purpose? What is he camping for? Well, looking at the vision at the moment, he doesn't see really anybody. He's going to run into Shiro now, though. We'll see the bottle there as well. And of course, well, the courier really unable to do anything. Or him unable to snipe the courier there. Monang, he's going to be solo up against a dual lane of Lakels and Boom Bell at the same time. Of course, Y2K, that means that he's going to be solo up against Batrider. Now that Nafari knows the lineup, lane matchup, he's gonna go back to the bottom lane. Boo Boo just comes into the mid lane though, throws out the last word onto my pro and backs off. Guess wants to make it so that Viper gets as good of a start as he can. Or at least maybe not as good of a start for the Viper, but as bad for the my pro Shadow Fiend. Oh god. My cat woke up or something and wants to go out. Ugh. Freaking hate when the cat is being obnoxious and whining way too much for random reasons. Although he whines even if he doesn't want to get out, so don't worry about that one, guys. But Monank definitely struggling for now. Does have two last hits, but compared to that to Lakel's is tiny. 5 and 3 now. Of course, tiny. Definitely nice base damage as well. 66 compared to Monank, 55. So a solid 11 on top of that. But last word comes out now. Lakel's will take some damage, but that is about it for now. It's mid lane. Viper, he should win this lane, to be honest. Especially now that he did get off to the greater, better start thanks to the silencer. Doing a little drive-by. So MyPro still sitting on 0. Does have 1 point in the Necromaster though, so he should be able to get last hits a hell of a lot easier than otherwise. But nice deny from SCL as well. 7 and 6 on the Viper. He's playing it exactly as you should as well. Just stay on the enemy high ground and completely zone off the Shadow Fiend if you can. Silencer picking up an Invis rune now as well. It was spotted out by the Observer, I think. Yeah, they should have seen it. They didn't see where he went exactly, but MyPro getting some help now from the IO as well, but Silencer coming in through behind. The sentry did get countered out beforehand. It was just on the edge of it as well. A little bit lucky I'd even consider it, to be honest. But Silencer still hanging about. Hasn't gone into sentry range, I think. Although he has to be a little bit careful of entering it. Yeah, he got pinged out of Boo-Boo. Gets just out of it, so no stun to follow. Another sentry's down, but Boo-Boo running the right way, yet his invis is about to wear off. But he got just far away, thanks to those boots that he started with. But look at it, Sig.Tr. They're once again swapping lanes. Of course, they do not want to face Try versus Try here. But Nafari already back to the top lane. It does mean that really low on levels on the Witch Doctor, but Sig.Tr just having to move around a little bit later, whereas the cores of the Prime have always been just static on their lanes, means that their cores have slightly better farm just due to that fact as well here. Looking at the stack status though, two stacks, or double stacks rather, in the medium as well as the big camp, and another double stack, so nicely done by the support for sure, just getting the first sentry down. Of course the second sentry may be kind of wasted, but they didn't even need that anyway since no more camps were really blocked out. So this ward, what is the Prime gonna do with this one? I mean, they see the stacks. Are they gonna steal it? Because it's a really risky thing to go for. Maybe they're gonna try to like go for the steal slash kills at the same time. As Boombell, he even used the magic missile to secure kill it. Oh, I missed first blood. SCL. Viper got himself the kill. Almost died himself, but has a healing cell, so he's gonna be just fine afterwards. Now, they're gonna see he was gonna get kited around a little bit. Last bird was there as well. SCL, of course, doesn't want to run back into the Firefly, which well, Boo-Boo gladly runs into. So they get the first blood, they make it away as well there. Top lane white, okay. Being a little bit abusive, especially knowing that Boombell doesn't really have enough mana for a magic missile. Even with an avalanche toss. I don't think Brewmaster would still die, but there's a paralyzing cask. Thunderclap will not follow at the moment. He's gonna save the Thunderclap for defensive purposes, I think. Or a better aggressive just timing there. Maybe they want to go on the Vengeful Spirit, which definitely possible. But Io comes in now. He's going to provide some mana to Boombell with the overcharge. He's going to make sure that he is low on mana. And White, okay, now in a lot of trouble. Gets the magic stick. But he's going to go down anyway. Thunderclap. Yes, one more attack. They get the kill. Just too much. The Io illusions, of course. Even tanking up the tower a little bit. Boombell with the healing cell will just be fine. So a nice kill there. Io coming in at a perfect timing. He in the meantime farming up the jungle. Already level 5. So, like I said, this ward, I just wasn't entirely clear of what that was supposed to accomplish. And I miss another kill, man. I am completely failing. Mid lane. Shadow Fiend goes down to SCL. God damn. Got to get my shit together. And Boo Boo gets a battery. Well, I guess that's what this ward is for. Okay. No point for me to try to look at chat or anything. Got to focus. Them delays, them pauses got me unfocused. Although that's no excuse, but Boo-Boo still hanging around. They might even go for another kill into MyPro, but then again, Viper Strike is already on cooldown. Viper himself is trying to bottle up, so maybe Poison Attack level 4 is going to be enough. Last word is there. Slows as well, but with the IO Terror movement speed, I think they're going to be able to turn things around. The Silence comes out now. Shiro, he may be the one to go down. Viper, is he going to be fast enough for another Poison Attack? No, he is not, I think. Although Corrosive Skin still slowing him down. One more attack. Yeah, that's gonna be the kill. The Wisp spirits screwed over the Io at the moment. Had he reined in, had he pulled in the spirits towards himself, it would have meant that they don't hit Viper and you don't get slowed down by the corrosive skin, which was the deciding factor now. So, 6 minutes in. There is an advantage to the Prime, not only in last hits, but also in kills. So things are going really well, especially me and Brewmaster, considering he's an offlaner. And, well, he's died once, but it's not that big of a deal, considering that he also got picked off once by a nice silencer rotation into the jungle there. So I was harping about this Observer Ward not paying off, but in the end, they got a kill with it, so it wasn't that bad for them. Also, I guess the knowledge of just knowing where the battle rider is or where the supports are at a given time is also worth something. But for Lang, 36 last hits, has the face boots, has the Morbid Mask as well. As now it is my duty to not miss a single kill, because I missed like most of the first ones. I'm really embarrassed about that, but what stun is stun, guys. Now there's a Freeman smoke instead. Boo Boo, only level 3, but last word level 2. Reasonable amount of damage coming out from that, but the Primal Split, the biggest thing for just Sig.Tr to worry about. And Boombell, well, he sees it, but Paralysis Cask will bounce once, but not back to anybody. And Boombell, he's gonna be fine, last word or not. Even gets off the minus armor to just not get disarmed at the same time. Boo Boo now. Does he want to screw with the Batrider? It sure feels like it, but Batrider is level 6, has the lasso, and Boo Boo might be just going in way over his head. Or new ward and back off. Looks like it. Don't go that way. Don't go that way. Yes. No. 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 If he runs into two of the heroes here, I think it's going to be screwed. Mid lane though. Do they want to go in SCL? Maybe so, but now seeing Boo Boo, they have a lasso if need be. But with the sticky napalm as well as the tether slow, it should be a really, like, really easy kill. At least last word comes out from the silencer to get some damage going. Viper Strike in the meantime is still... he's gonna lose his life! Oh god, he tried to go and help, but he just got kind of ganked himself. Witch Doctor, well, they get the kill on Lakels with the help of the Brewmaster split. Tiny almost managed to blow up the Witch Doctor there. So 5-4 now the kill score. Viper, huge misstep there trying to go and help, to be honest, because silencer, he was screwed anyway. If maybe Silencer had it just try to run straight to the bottom here, but then again, I think he saw the Vengeful Spirit coming in, possibly. Or the Shadow Fiend. So they were doomed no matter what. Sometimes, especially if it's support, you should just be like, screw it. That support is dead. I cannot help him. And just let him be. Let him die. Now though, instead, Batrider has himself a pre-9-minute Blink Dagger. So Blink Lasso will be available for Hehe now. Just a second. Stop spoiling for people. Just because some streams do not have the required 5-minute delay, which is a little bit silly that we have to have a 5-minute delay, but that was what the tournament admins. As far as Monag now. Oh no, the lasso onto a creep! Oh no, Batrider, please! Oh Hehe. What a mistake Otomeko. So yeah, just because there's a 5-minute delay on this one. Please do not spoil things on chat for the other ones, okay? Nice, thank you. So I had to time you out for now, but it is nice to spoil scores and everything. It takes away the fun of a live game, people. But looking at farm, the Prime still doing reasonably well. I mean, Shadow Fiend really hasn't taken off. I mean, he is level 8, so that's not bad. There's Lakels now. He's gonna find Nafari. Oh god, Avalanche. Was there toss to follow? Lakels, of course, got maledicted himself. Y2K body blocked a little bit as he they find the kill on the silencer. So Boo Boo really not having a good game in his level 4, 10 minutes in. I guess you not just pulling through constantly on the safe lane does that to you. As Monang, with the help of the healing ward, gonna go for the tier 1. Glyph is forced, but he should still be getting this last hit here. He's even gone for 3 points into the healing ward. That's a little bit unusual, but I guess they have reasonably tanky heroes with the Brewmaster and the Viper there to make great use of that percentage-based heal. So, I guess the average Blink Dagger is like 11-12 minutes in, but he got the early Blink Dagger to lasso a creep. It's still fine, but of course, he did show off the Blink Dagger, and now the Prime know what to expect, although you can't always know when the Batrider or from where the Batrider will jump you. Even then, just the fact that you know that there's a blink dagger on the enemy bat finished, you're gonna inherently, or at least usually most players' teams will play a little bit more safely due to that fact. SCL though, of course, working towards his mech on the Viper, only 400 gold away, even has a haste room bottled up, so no matter what's thrown his way, he should be able to haste his way to safety. As now, there's the blink onto Y2K. They should have the magic missile to follow, and with that, enough damage, or never mind. No magic missile, Boombell, waiting a little bit too long, and suddenly he might be in a little bit of trouble. But since the Thunderclap didn't come out before, he may just be able to escape. Now, with the help of Shiro, he definitely will be, I think. And man, my cat is just all kinds of crazy. Hopefully, he's not gonna pee inside or do even worse. But SCL, going a little bit too deep, does dodge the avalanche, so he's gonna be fine. Swap is there, toss onto a creep. He's still alive, but for how long is the question? He's gonna lose his life, or is he paralyzing Cask to the rescue? Nafari shows up just at the right time, as I wish I had somebody else home just to let my cat outside. But Tiny gets the kill in the end anyway. That was by no means worth it to just rush for a vengeful spirit like that. Oh god, the prime. It feels a little bit like last game's mistake, just going in a little bit too deep at times. Well, he did purchase up the mech recipe before, so that's nice, but... Well, fight recap. Gold change wasn't all that big of a difference, I suppose. XP-wise, not that great of a deal, but... Just slowing down the Viper is already worth something, as Boo Boo now in the trees, gonna TP out just before the avalanche stuns him out. But silencer still, so far, not the greatest impact this game, really. And that's the biggest problem with, especially support silencer, and should you not run a, like, standard defensive tri-lane, is that... You may not be able to do anything, like anything at all, as Monang now. Just magic missile toss, no avalanche even needed for that kill, with the shadow races to help out, of course. So another kill for Sig.Tr. The Prime, they have a Viper, they have a Brewmaster, and the mech is finished. Hopefully once the Primal Spit comes off cooldown, maybe they're gonna have a bottom lane. They get the a lasso up onto the Viper. So Viper, he just respawned, came to a lane, died again. So Sig.Tr at the moment, they are outmaneuvering the side of the Prime. I mean, the Prime, they had excellent farm, but the same could have been said for game number one, really. Laning went pretty decently, Enigma got a lot of farm in the jungle, but they were just unable to really heavily capitalize on the fact that they were ahead with XP and net worth early on. So Sig.Tr looking good, they get themselves a tower down, 1.3k on the kills now after the treads, magic wand and drums. Shadowfiend also up to 2.4k gold, top lane, well, there are some drawings, but is it to relocate there? Maybe so. I mean, Tiny, when he has enough mana, just avalanche toss, which Dr. Dead, he's killed. I mean, both spells are maxed out. Tiny's already level 11, and he was part of a, well, mostly dual lane, I suppose. But Blink, after the tower kill, is picked up on Brewmaster, so having the Blink, having the mech, they really should fight, but then again, fighting into Tiny is never easy, but there's the avalanche toss, wave of terror to help out a little bit, although not really necessary. Solo kills, another kill for the Tiny, has his point booster finished. If the IO Tiny take off, I am extremely scared for the Prime. I mean, at least now Silencer is level 6, so they have a little bit more going for them. But the Prime trying to go for Roshan, they have a healing ward level 3, so they should be able to do this. Mask of Man is there as well, of course. So Monang gonna be at full HP, but even with the Viper being there, it's gonna take them quite some time to get it down. Especially if Monang gets bashed by Roshan. But it's down to half HP, Mask of Madness when it comes off cooldown, that should be enough duration to just finish up Roshan completely. Vengeful is coming close by, but he may not have any idea about this going on. So he's just gonna, stack Ancients. I thought maybe wards are coming out, but Roshan down. Really well done, Monang now, having the Aegis, having the safety of that item. So at least they have that going for them. Of course, some nice golden XP from the kill of Roshan, but other than that, net worth, only a 1k difference now. XP in the favor of Sig.Tr by about 2500 or so. But the Prime, they're trying to pressure a tier 1 now as well. So maybe they are completely grouping up. I mean, they have the global silence. Why not group up and force things when you can, when you know that you should be able to at least take a fight? Even if there's a lasso, unless it's on the silencer, it should be perfectly fine. Healing ward, also already used. Maybe a little bit preemptive, but better safe than sorry. At least, like, try to force out an attack from the Batrider. Tower does go down, Batrider. Try to go for a sneaky deny, but not this time. Now, the tier 1 tower on top might be the trade here. Toss used as well, of course. Toss does damage to buildings as well. Not too many abilities in the game of Dota that do damage to buildings, but Toss, one of those. But they're going for a tier 2 as well. They really want to go. I mean, SL has a level 2 Viper Strike. Definitely nice to just deal with. Maybe even a Shadow Fiend, who has a Yule Scepter, so a little bit of extra movement speed. But if you're slowed by a Poison Attack or Viper Strike, that doesn't really help you. And don't Omni Slash it, it's obvious it's an illusion. And yeah, SL just going to take care of one Nafari, the other one here. So they're still going to keep on going. But then again, so is Sig.Tr. So it might be a tier 1 for tier 1 and tier 2 for tier 2, unless they TP back and stop Lakels now. Who, well, only one piece worth of gold short from that Aghanim Scepter at all. No, Batrider. Never mind, Blinks out. It's really not that easy to catch a hero with a Blink Dagger when you don't have any Blink Initiation yourself. Well, they have the Brewmaster, but Brewmaster was already backing off by that time. Alright, okay, he still wants to keep on going. Blink Thunderclap catches the kills. Global Silence as well to stop that IO's Relocate from coming out. And Storm Panda goes a little bit off the target, and that's just tiny save. The idea was nice, but them not having proper vision of IO completely screwed them up. Storm Panda slightly off target as well. Are they going to come back with the two of them? No, it's just the IO. Of course, there will be no escape from this one, but four heroes were grouped up for that. Monang farming the ancients at the same time, so they're getting something farmed. But look at my pro. He's going to get the tier 1 or tier 2 bottom lane. Probably not going to be able to completely secure it and finish it up, but it's slow enough for it to get backdoored, even if they really need to later on. Hehe though, working towards a 4-staff. Wow, this is really close to that one as well. So this Batrider has had a reasonable game, of course. The first showing of the Blink Dagger lassoing a creep wasn't the greatest, but other than that, not a bad game at all. When it gets the 4-staff, it's gonna get better still. Aegis though will be reclaimed in 1 minute and 50 seconds. So hopefully they're gonna make proper use of that as well. They have the level 2 Omni Slash. They still have all of their ultimates. Well, not what I'm saying. No Primal Split for another 60 seconds. Thought it was maybe a little bit less time of go, but there's the Omni Slash. He will go down, even try to TP out, but there was no chance, like no chance at all for him to get out. But then again, Lakels gets himself a tier 2 at the same time, so it's gonna be a tower for tower. But Lakels already pressing the tier 3. Not for too long though, since only one TP back already makes him back off. But mid lane, Boo Boo on the Silencer is in messed up. Will get the last word, but will it even do anything? Well, maybe with the help of the Thunderclap. There is the Requiem Souls. Oh, missed time though. Lakels and Tiny, they relocate in. It's going to be an easy kill onto the Brewmaster. Boo Boo to go down next. That's just the power of IO Relocate. And since many teams don't really play IO these days, you're not that used to just an IO Relocate coming in to help. So that was a little bit too deep. Shadow Fiend just buying enough time with the Yule Scepter. And of course, Primal Split being on cooldown anyway. So another two kills for Sig.Tr there. Juggernaut does have some pretty nice farm, but if I would have to choose between IO Tiny and the Juggernaut, I'd definitely go with IO Tiny. Plus, not only that, they have a Batrider for excellent initiations throughout the game. And of course, also a Shadow Fiend to back up with damage output. And just having the presence of the Dark Lord close by already helps out the Tiny a great deal. Who has the Aghanims, another Blade of Alacrity, so going for a Yasha next. Unless it's a Diffusal Blade, which I highly doubt it. I think straight out Manta Style to get rid of the Global Silence for the Tiny. Although you don't rely that much on Avalanche Toss, it's just an easy extra source of damage, really. So there's a smoke now, also purchased by Hehe on the Batrider. Level 11, level 2 lasso. I mean, damage-wise, duration-wise, not that big of a difference. I mean, damage-wise, no difference, or it doesn't do any damage at all, so never mind that. But just 0.5 seconds extra disable. It's like Electric Vortex on the Storm Spirit gets the same amount of increment per level. But it's really the cooldown reduction that you're looking for as the with the Batrider ultimate. As Nafari up to 1.7k gold. What's he holding for on the Witch Doctor? I would like to see just maybe Medallion of Courage or otherwise just... Well, they get the lasso. Are we going to have a relocate? Well, since they saw the Brewmaster, I don't think they're going to relocate anymore. Hehe now, he's going to TP out and he's going to manage to do so. Got away from Nafari's Paralyzing Cast. And in the meantime, top lane, they're going to lose a tier 2 Lakel with the Yasha finished now. Another 1.2k on top of that. this tiniest farm is just increasing way too fast, and what's gonna stop them anytime soon? I mean, the Prime, they got their Blink Dagger on the Brewmaster within a reasonable timing. They got the mech on Viper as well pretty fast, but after that, it's just when they want to fireman group and fight, which is more or less the only way the Prime should fight, they just keep on split pushing, and well, now they go in Avalanche Toss, which Doctor down. Oh wow, this game really isn't going as planned for the Prime at the moment. Sig.Tr, of course, if for them, they won game number, well, game number two, I suppose. So they won the game, feeling confident, just coming into this one with some momentum, and having it go as it is so far, definitely must be feeling good. I mean, it's not like they have a huge lead, but they have a lead, so that's pretty nice already, plus IO Tiny just wrecks face, kind of. About a 2k network lead soon enough for them, 5k in XP, and yeah, as the graphs update, 2500 in net worth as well. Hehe. Even gonna stack up those Ancients for them now. Boombell, of course, has the Medallion of Courage, so Roshan is gonna be extremely easy. Presence of the Dark Lord, Wave of Terror, and Medallion of Courage. Roshan is just gonna melt to them. 2.6k now on STL, so his Aghanim Scepter, if that is the choice with that point booster, which I'd say with a 99.9% certainty that it will be. Unless he wants to go for Bloodstone, which I hope he doesn't, but he, you know, gonna get stunned. Yep, the Omni Slash even comes out, the Relocate coming in, Global Silence, maybe a little bit too late, but Monang, just run the hell out of there if you can. But Mask of Madness already used, swap back into so many heroes. Avalanche a little bit too early though, Use Scepter does dodge the, or well, Lakels makes Monang dodge. Now the mech is there from SCL, he slows down Lakels. Is it really a turnaround? Mypro taking a lot of damage, Blink, Thunderclap, Primal Split was used, so Mypro, he's on the run now, got off his ultimate, but it's not gonna be enough. Healing Ward, following Monang, still might go down, nope. Healing Ward, OP guys, but do not stay together for the... Never mind, it's fine, they throw him up in there. They kind of really went into cleave range, SCL, no reason for him to be that close, but suddenly Lakels, he's the one on the run. Do they have a stun, anything to stop it with? Nope, but Monang definitely did get stunned by the craggy exterior there. Has a Skadi already finished, so farm still pretty nice, plus this was an excellent fight, getting 3 kills like that. All of them surviving. Juggernaut, for a second I thought he's gonna die. Swapped back in as well, but Tiny just a little bit too trigger happy with that avalanche there. Mistimed it, so Blade Fury got him out. Then Shadow Fiend used the Yule Scepter, which made Juggernaut not take damage from the toss of the Tiny as well. Now though, oh god, Monang. Well, just as I was praising him from surviving, now he's probably gonna go down, or is he? Nope. Blade Fury TP out. Nobody there was close by. Vengeance Spirit just couldn't get there in time for the swap to cancel the TP. But 14 to 11 now is the kill score. If you're Sig.Tr, I still think you're pretty comfortable about the situation you're in. Just because, first of all, Tiny is a tanky bastard, but Roshan not up yet. Kind of a long respawn. Oh god, Hasted, Batrider, that is scary, but Lasso on cooldown, so maybe not as scary. Blink Thunderclap is there as well, but no Primal Split. No Omni Slash for another 9 seconds, Lakil. Maybe not the best target to focus, but, well, it's the target that they got the slows on. Now Boombell will lose his life as he swaps out Lakil's a little bit farther away. Of course, Tiny's gonna come back. He still hanging about, being just annoying with that sticky napalm, if nothing else. Monang, though, he's waiting for it. No need to use the Omni Slash. Easy 2 intelligence for Boo Boo there, 12 points in total, but Roshan still not up. In the meantime, Manta Style finished on Lakels, 1k after that as well. So Global Silence, at least for the Tiny, won't matter that much, unless he preemptively Mantas, which he really shouldn't. Top lane though, Mypro, he's just pushing in, split push Shadow Fiend. Maybe not the fastest pusher, but at least he clears like... He's still extremely fast, don't get me wrong, but there are a couple of heroes who can do it faster still. But he just clears up the creep wave so fast that your own creep wave will be at full HP, like a double creep wave, maybe triple one. Just because your creep shouldn't take any damage from the enemy ones almost. 2 Shadow Races, creep wave down. Next creep wave, same story. Lakels now, even farming up Ancients, like he doesn't have enough gold. So Graf still about a 2k difference in net worth. XP getting closer to zero as Global Silence comes out mid lane. They get Mypro, Death Requiem still does something, but they have the Healing Ward. They're gonna be perfectly fine with that. So another huge kill there for them. Of course, Global Science being on cooldown is also kind of a big deal. So Sig.Tr, maybe they're gonna go look for a fight. Now that they know the Roshan is going on, they don't really want to go for it without the Shadow Fiend though. First of all, Shadow Fiend provides additional minus armor, so that's nice. Whereas the Prime Firefly ends now, so they're gonna go for it. They though don't have any minus armor sources. My Pro buys back as well, so if I was Prime, I'd back off now. Minus armor on the Roshan might even help them out a little, but they don't have any healing ward. Basher is delivered to Manang. They have all of their ultimates apart from the Global Science Y2K. Get Shadow Raised a little bit. Mech is there. They really want to go for My Pro, and if they get the kill, it's nice, but he still has the Yule Scepter, so you can't really Omni Slash him, but Io Sky, he will slow him down. Get some distance before he blows up with the Death Requiem. Nope, they don't care. Shadow Fiend, oh yeah, he didn't even have max souls, he only had 18. Now there is a lag spike. So, go has been given straight after the kill on Shadow Fiend. Of course, there was no saving the Shadow Fiend, but a huge kill. Shadow Fiend just bought back for that as well. Only down to 9 Necromastery souls now. Oh god, that's horrible, Manang. He's in the Firefly, doesn't care. He's gonna pop down the healing ward, he is. Of course, he shouldn't stay in the Firefly because that's just unnecessary damage he's taking. I don't know why he's doing that. It's not like he has the Aegis. He could have just stepped like one step to the left and be fine. Boombell does get silenced just before I think he wanted to go for a magic missile. Like tiny illusions in the meantime, forcing back at least the Viper. So 15 to 15 now with the kill score evened up by the Prime. They know a couple of heroes are close by. 3k gold on Lakel. Man, he is getting farm and he is getting it fast. But Roshan is the next attempt. Healing ward, of course, now on cooldown. And they still have the battery. Battery just drag one out. Monang, he's gonna be the target. Has the Omni Slash. But he's on the heal. He can Omni Slash down though. There's the death ward as well. Omni Slash, maybe not the greatest idea. Purely into illusions for the start. They get Boombell nonetheless though. Omni Slash level 3, I guess, just has enough bounces now though. He's gonna lose his life. Oh, why didn't he just play if he just got Avat tossed? He gonna lose his life to the Brulings, but they can't get Roshan without the Juggernaut, so still a little bit weird of an engagement in the end. They even buy back on the Juggernaut, same for the Batrider and the Witch Doctor, so definitely a little bit weird there. Sig.Tr, I think they got the upper hand there. They got the kill on Juggernaut, forced him to buy back, whereas Juggernaut is like the hero that has to carry the Prime this game. At least they had Global Science of cooldown, so they have something. Juggernaut already back to Roshan, gets himself a GG rune, the double damage rune. And it's... Oh no, Aegis Batrider steals it! They were so focused on trying to hit the Batrider, they didn't pick up the Aegis there. Oh, second game in a row, the Prime just getting screwed over. And look at this, relocating Lakels, wants to go for a tier 3, probably gonna get it as well. They need to be able to stop Shiror, need to be able to just split them up somehow. Lakels takes quite a bit of damage, but it's not nearly enough. Focus fire wasn't really there, Boo. He couldn't go past the Tiny towards the Io, because otherwise Tiny may just turn around, Avalanche Toss, and kill the Silencer there. And so, they don't get Aegis. They almost lose a tier 3 tower, which, well, the Siege Creep will finish now, I think. Sig.Tr, they're really just toying around with the Prime, it feels like. They are directing the movements of the Prime for the most part. It's just the weakness of the lineup that the Prime went for. They are really best at just 5-man brawling, kind of, fighting as 5. But 2500 now for Y2K's Brewmaster. Picks up a Hyperstone, so AC will be in the making, but it's not going to be there for quite some time still. I mean, there's just item progression isn't all that great. They're not winning that many fights, at least not too decisively. They're not really getting any towers because a lot of them have already been destroyed, of course. So, the AC, definitely gonna be a nice item once it comes out. Monang, Abyssal Blade, the same for him, but damn, just that Aegis steal was so huge. Last game, of course, it was even bigger because it was the Storm Spirit getting the Aegis. Now it's the Batrider, but it's still like an annoying thing to go up against, especially now that he has a gem on the Batrider. It just means that he can breathe a little bit more safely. Whereas Lakels now picks up a Hyperstone off his own, and he is way closer to the AC than the Doom Master is, even with all the items in addition that he has. So, kill score at least is even. Looking at the graphs though, about a 3k net worth lead for Sig.Tr. XP 2500 in the favor of the Prime. So, game is anybody's to take, but the longer it goes, the harder it comes for Sig.Tr. Although then again, my pro, if he loses his life, gonna get slowed down, swapped there onto an illusion by Pumbel. He's gonna lose his life. Global Silence comes out as they relocate this there, but Laquelle's Manta's out of it. Monang now, he is completely surrounded, goes down as well. Didn't even get to use the Omnislash for some weird reason. Now Shiro, he's on the run from the Broolings, and well, relocate gets him to safety. Pupu, he arrives, but can't even do anything. I mean, he gets the last word, long range one onto my pro. But Laquelle's Avalanche toss, a few smacks. The dodge just isn't enough, or is it? Drunken Haze is there as well, Yule Scepter for Mypro once again. Nope, they get the kill on Y2K, and well, what did the Prime get? Only a Vengeful Spirit. Laquelle's with the Mantle Style, just thought Global Silence might buy enough time, but then again. No, the dodge with the Mantle Style of the Viper Strike. Beautiful stuff. Do we have a Lasso? We still do. Escheel, don't think he's going to be able to outrun this. He wants to keep on to the Lasso if he can. There's the toss, gets the Batterer, 3 stacks of Sticky Napalm. Laquelle's just right clicks him down, and well, Viper, you only want to have buyback out of the 3 dead heroes. And he's forced to use it as well, but I don't think it's going to be able to just save Rex for them. They still have Aegis and Sig.Tr. This kind of signals the start of the end of the game here. They get the Blink Lasso onto Escheel. Oh god, it's going to be a dieback. Requiem of Souls to secure the kill easily. So, Laquelle's under the effects of Maledict. Gets stunned up a little bit, but well, the toss, the illusions, the damage way too much. They still have it like a 10 second time window, and that 10 seconds might be enough. It's just Viper not being there, silencer, nor the silencer that is for quite some time. Laquelle's Avalanche into Nafari, toss to follow, another kill for them. 2 racks advantage, and well, the Prime, I have to say. Or is it the 2 racks advantage? They're not going for it. Laquelle, just go! Right click it. Batra just leaves behind a trail of Firefly. Probably wants to disable Blink Daggers if he can. So, yeah. 18 to 24. It used to be 17 to 17, guys. The Prime only get one kill, whereas Sig.Tr grab 7 kills, grab 2 racks, and well, there's still a chance for a comeback, but I just think that there's not much of a chance for that one. They really need to play perfectly now, and not only that, Sig.Tr also needs to screw up at the same time. Batterer even gets a Shadow Play just because he can. And since there's no detection, at least I don't think there's any detection. Yeah, none. They can't do anything, and although Silencer, Global Silence is all nice and good, but this game, Silencer just hasn't really had the desired effect. Laquelle's though, he's gonna get caught. Blink Thunderclap, nicely done. Global Silence as well to prevent the relocate from coming out. Pumbel gets the swap onto the Tiny, so they save the Tiny. And once again, they only lose the Vengeful for a Global Silence and an Omnislash and a Primal Split. It's not a bad trade at all, to be honest. Can they get the IO now as well, though? The Kudir, oh no, Kudir, what are we doing here? Okay, so they lose the Kudir. Shiro will lose his own life. Lasso came in from Hee Hee, who, well, Aegis just got reclaimed a little bit earlier, I think. So they get the secondary kill plus the Kudir, so that's not that bad. Plus, they're in a reasonable position to maybe go high ground, but without their ultimates being up, not entirely sure if they're gonna just try to brute force this. I can understand that they may feel like they need to do this, and it may not even be a wrong understanding for them, but it's extremely scary to go for it. Looking at the buyback status for the Dire side, IO and the Tiny, the ones to have it. Shadowfin though has gotten slightly tankier, of course. Double ultimate orb now towards the Die of Skadi. Escheel in the front lines. Viper Strike into Laquelle's, once again dodged by the Manta Stages. Great usage. Laquelle's definitely, I mean, it's not like the hardest thing to do, but Laquelle's showing some pretty nice Tiny plays. Has a Demon Edge, so maybe Crystal is into Daedalus next. Maybe Monkey King Bar, considering you are up against a Brewmaster. Either one will be fine. I mean, he's hitting plenty hard already, especially with the help of the Vengeance Aura. One of the better just heroes to complement Pumbel, but we're gonna have a backdoor relocate in. Tier 4 time, they can't of course go for triple rack just because it's not possible. But in the meantime, Pumbel gonna lose his own life. I think Viper Strike to slow him down. Stunned up by the Basher as well. Mypro will survive somehow. Now Shiro relocates back. He's gonna leave Laquelle's to just do his business. Ancient taking a lot of damage. Y2K gets stunned up. They need to kill the illusions. Do not chase for the kill. Kill the illusions, guys. Illusions are killing the ancients. In the meantime, Nafari goes with the death ward. Gets one kill already. Mypro will be the second one to fall. The death Requiem though gets the counter kill, and SCL on the run. May even lose his life. Mech keeps him alive a little while longer, but Monang TP out the tier. Oh. Tier 3 plus his attacks, too much for them to handle. Buybacks though from the Witch Doctor as well as the Juggernaut. Come on, kill Laquelle's, at least they need that little bit. Maledict is there, Avalanche. Oh god, look at Monang. Toss as well. Are you kidding me? Healing Ward. No, it's not enough. That's a dieback. Lakels. He just man-moded. Lose the Brewmaster. Lakels will lose his own life, but GG is called. Buyback on the Tiny. It's just too much for them to handle. Oh wow. Man, the swings are real. Swings are real. Easy win. Easy win for Sig.Tr. It was such an even game. Just look at the graphs. Not that big of a deal at all. Suddenly, one nice fight escalated into a couple of extra pickoffs, into double racks, and now just backdooring IO Tiny. Sig.Tr. Trust definitely, when in doubt, pick up IO Tiny for them. But guys, this will mean that Sig.Tr. Trust, they do win the Prime major tournament. Little bit of a letdown for the Prime themselves. Would have been nice to win their own tournament for sure, but up until the final, had a spotless run, and they still secure themselves a second spot, some prize money as well. For the top place, it's $1,000 or just about. For the second place, $500. So maybe not that big of a deal, but if you're in Southeast Asia, any little bit will help for sure. But guys, this will conclude the broadcast for the day. Thank you so much for tuning in and supporting us. Unfortunately, it was a solo cast by me, but well, what can you do? Have to live with it, guys. Also, sorry for missing kills early on, but later on, didn't miss all that many. Or if I did, it's only because there was action on two different places at the same time. In any case, guys, if you liked it and want to see more of HeflaTV's casting, check out our facial media all the time? Social media, Facebook and Twitter. It is HeflaTV for both. It's at Couchor for me personally, everywhere more or less. You can find me if you just search for Couchor. And well, having said that, guys, once again, appreciated that you came, and just hope to see you another day with some, hopefully, more great Southeast Asian content. And yes, watch Monang's highlight video. It is on our YouTube. It is a just highlight of how Monang managed to survive on the Storm Spirit through an entire teamfight, whereas he got focused, maybe not too highly, but some focus was on the Storm Spirit, but great supports, support heals, of course. Phoenix, with the Sunray, Hand of God, from the Chen, of course, so check it out on our YouTube, for sure. It should be the trailer of the channel, so to say, but with that, guys, we're done here. Just some songs to finish the stream, and have a good one.